Hi, so today I'm going to make radish soup with just 5 ingredients. So they are radish, carrots, tofu, black eyed peas, and chicken. So because I only left with 1 piece of chicken at home and I'm supposed to cook for 7 people, so I need around 700 grams of protein food. Okay, so I have added in quite a large amount of black eyed peas, so this is around 200 grams, 300 grams, and I guess this is around 250 grams of chicken. So with that, it will make up around 700 grams. Then same thing for the radish and carrot, I consider them as a vegetable. So this is around 400 grams and these are 300 grams. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm basically just going to add the proteins in, and I'm going to skin the radish and then cut it, okay, and then just put it in. So it's a very easy dish. Okay, once I'm done, I'll just add water and then cook it in the pressure cooker. So let's get started. So first, I will skin it and then cut it, alright? Alright, I finished dicing the radish. So you notice I like it to be bite-sized pieces. Reason is because it's for kids. Kids will be eating it as well. And another reason is because I like the taste of the radish when it soaks up all the soup, right? So having smaller pieces means larger surface area, so you absorb more soup. Okay, and also don't throw away the greens that are at the top of the radish. Okay, they are edible and they are also they taste like radish, but well, they have more fiber. So don't waste it. So I'm also going to put it in. So now I've added the radish. Okay, so now next I'm going to do the same for the carrot. So I'm going to peel off the outer covering of the carrot and then dice it. Okay, I'm done with the carrots. So today I decided everything should be bite size, so the carrots are also bite size. So now they will go in to the pressure cooker. Okay, that weighs nothing. Make sure I put everything in. Okay, so now that I'm done with the carrots, the next thing will be my black eyed peas. So this one I've washed them with water already, so just put them in. So basically what you need to do is just rinse them with water, then pour off the water. And finally, I'll top it up with this tofu here. Okay, so usually I don't cut my tofu because after it goes into the pressure cooker, it will become small pieces. Same thing for the chicken. So with that, I'm going to add in two big bowls of water. One bowl, two bowls. So here is my rice cooker that I always use and my pressure cooker here. So for this dish here, right, you might like to add in some salt, a bit of salt. Okay, so that it takes for taste. Okay, but for me, because it's for kids to eat as well, right? So I'm not gonna add salt. Okay, the carrots are sweet, so at the end of the day, it will have a sweet taste. Okay, so now let me cover up. So now it's in the pressure cooker already. So I'm going to cover it up. Okay, and then start cooking. Okay, so now I've covered up. Make sure that it is in the pressure mode, which is in the center here. Okay, if not, you will have a lot of the steam bubbling out during the process. Then you won't have pressure cooking. Okay. Okay, so I'll press soup and start. Okay, so now what I need to do is just wait for it to be cooked. Wow, my radish soup is ready. Okay, so okay, the tofu didn't break up, but I'll use my ladle here to break it up. Let me break up the tofu. Okay, another thing that I want to break up is the piece of chicken which is at the bottom. Yes. Okay, one thing I want to show you is, look at the soup. Wow. It's not clear soup anymore, it's brown.
and it has a very strong smell of the radish as well as the chicken. It's going to be very nice.
Always I'm going to put the dinner inside here and then have the rest for lunch.
So this is dinner. Clap it.
I would say this is really sweet. The soup is really sweet because of all the carrots and the radish.
See you! Like and subscribe!